And joining us now to break down these latest developments is Representative Debbie Lesko, the congresswoman serving Arizona's 8th District. So, Congresswoman, I know that you were part of the impeachment saga. Of course, you were on President Trump's defense team, one of the surrogates there, speaking out on that throughout the process. Hakeem Jeffries said that people who questioned the dossier were conspiracy theorists. So, your response.
Oh, he's full of BS. He was then, and now it's proven, right? And this is what the Democrats do. They just say false things. They call us, you know, right-wing nut jobs and all kinds of stuff. It continues to this day. And you can see from all of this, it's like a spy novel. I'm telling you, I was reading the Federalist and report, and it's like reading a spy novel, what they did to spy on President Trump and the Trump campaign. It's just absolutely outrageous. And then you have these FBI agents texting back and forth. If you don't mind, I'm going to read you a couple of them.
By all means.
Because it's really something. So one of the FBI says, FYI, someone leaked the Flynn calls with Kislyak to the Wall Street Journal, the agent wrote. Then another agent replies, it's got to be someone on staff, an agent wrote. Presidential daily briefing staff or White House seniors. And this goes all the way up to the Oval Office. I think it was January 5th when you had Biden in the room, Obama in the room. They're talking about this. The corruptness that has gone on going after President Trump, these Democrats just do not believe that President Trump could be elected, or they want to oust him. And millions of people voted for President Trump. This is just outrageous. And the other day in Judiciary Committee, I got to talk to FBI Director Christopher Wray just about all of this stuff that was going on in the FBI and what are they doing to clean it up. And I really need to hear more from him because this is very unsettling. If this kind of stuff can happen to the President of the United States, yeah. You know darn well that it could happen to you and me.
And I'm glad you brought up those text messages, because one that I know a lot of our viewers really focus on is that insurance policy text of what that means. Now, we still don't have a definitive answer, but we do know that Mueller investigators took out a literal insurance policy to really escape liability in case this investigation were to go haywire. I mean, that within itself does not really instill confidence among those investigators to begin with. But I'm glad you bring up FBI Director Christopher Wray, because we did show that clip of him, and he has been appearing before lawmakers to answer some questions. But a lot of your colleagues, for example, say that his answers do not suffice given the seriousness of this moment. So do you have faith in not only FBI Director Christopher Wray, but the rest of the Bureau regarding this issue?
Well, I have faith in Attorney General Barr, and so I certainly hope that he will clean up this mess that's going on in the FBI and some of the DOJ. I mean, this is just corruptness at its worst, going all the way up to President Obama in the Oval Office with Joe Biden. This is just insanity. And the other thing that I talked to Christopher Wray about when he was in Judiciary the other day is we talked about Antifa, and it really concerns me that he doesn't call it an organization. He kept saying it was an ideology. Well, when they're coordinating, when there's obviously somebody paying all the bills for all these rioters and looters, flying them around the entire country, that kind of concerns me why you wouldn't call it an organization. That concerns me too.
Yeah, and I mean, we have seen it ourselves. I don't know where this narrative is coming from necessarily, where some people will say that Antifa does not exist. They're like, anti-fascist, it's a broad term for people who don't like fascists. That is not the case at all. In fact, it is such a naive way to put it, because we have seen people spray painting Antifa logos. We have seen them carrying the flag through these protests. We showed it last night on this program. So it's just a little bit escape from reality to me for that narrative to come through. But I do want to touch on something you just said as well about how high this goes. You bring up, for example, former Vice President Joe Biden and his involvement. He's thought to be the one, according to the FBI, who first brought up the Logan Act to use against Michael Flynn to kick this whole thing off. How important is it that Durham's report gets out before the election, acknowledging the fact that Biden could win the election and therefore suppress this?
Oh gosh, I've been waiting for the Durham report forever. I hope it comes out soon, and I hope people get charged criminally. I mean, come on. You have FBI agents that are doctoring FISA documents and applications, all kinds of stuff going on here. And they even said that Flynn did nothing wrong. They closed the investigation. Then all of a sudden they reopened it up again. I think Peter Strzok was involved in that. And then, like you said, it went into the Oval Office and Joe Biden and President Obama even talked about again. And then it's reopened. And then you have these agents saying expletives in their texts like, oh my gosh, they've reopened it again. Who is leaking this stuff? It's going all the way up to the White House. This is like a spy novel. I mean, it was really interesting, but terrible at the same time.
No, you're exactly right. And in fact, it's Peter Strzok's own notes that you're talking about right now that are detailing the very events that we're talking about. So we don't have to speculate any further. I think a lot of this information is finally coming forward. But Congresswoman Debbie Lesko, it's always a pleasure having you on this program. Thank you for breaking this down for us.
Thank you.
And still